Ready? I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing. I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
That wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen!
You're insane! That explosion was massive!
You say that like it's a bad thing.
Pretty sure your mom would think so. Let's hope she didn't hear.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now. Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Well, besides Bongo, of course. Oh, this was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts. All right. Back to the junk mines.
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
That's BS. The last time we played, I wiped the floor with you.
Poor Max. Losing your memory at such a young age. Guess we'll have to play again soon and find out.
I can see why Chloe has such a hard time cleaning out her room. Oof. Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, O almighty Chloe Bear. As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I can never tell if Chloe is my best friend because she makes me do crazy things, or despite it. Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool. I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter. I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks. People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool. I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
This seems like a good candidate. Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowances cost?
You haven't touched these since the fifth grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
So hard to believe. This room, this house, this town. All in the past now. Or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things, pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't. I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her. Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now. We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it. What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away. Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures. Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies. Whoa. Talk about embarrassing. How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Live fast, die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll.
What are you doing?
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by mistake, right?
No. It's fine. It's filled with holes and falling apart.
That never stopped you from wearing it before.
It's fine. Really.
I've tried my best to clean this place. I should check in with Chloe now. That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two under-supervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later. Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. I
don't know how
to... Shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! Ye have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia! Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver!
We were such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches.
Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it.
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek, but be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, bye.
Dude, that was...
So dorky. What were we thinking?
I thought we were lovable. Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. Where could it be? Huh. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. Chloe's so determined to find the map. I love how when she puts her mind to something, she just doesn't give up. Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude. Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try. I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens. Wonder if I could still get to the end.
Yes! Take that, Rat King. Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year. Chloe's so determined to find the map. Any luck?
Nope. You?
Nothing yet. This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. I think this was the first class Chloe and I had together. Not sure I learned much about the Stars and Stripes. Bingo. I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet.
Which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic!
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still there?
Should be, as long as the clean police haven't gotten to it first.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver right again, bitches!
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure. Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet. Favorite place in the house, but I need to head to the attic. Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last scheme we ever plan here. I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer. The entrance to the dark cavern is in there. Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet. It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it. I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to. The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years. I slipped and broke this post a few years ago, but Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend. I don't think I've ever actually seen anyone reading these books. I wonder if I'll ever take this view in again. Awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it. Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time? Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Oh, so cool. Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it. Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking. Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little strange when I asked her about school earlier. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about. Did Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings. The two whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close. It's so sweet that Chloe's mom takes this photo with her to work. Aw, Chloe's parents are so cute. I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation. I've I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back. There it is. The dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up. Maybe this will make me tall enough to reach. It's a start. Something I can stack on top of it. I think that'll be a good base to stack things on. It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. Big enough for me to reach, but maybe I can stack things on top of it. Almost there. I just need a few more inches. Not bad for an improvised stepladder, but it's still not tall enough. Inches to reach the attic. Chloe's room has always been home base. I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to. Probably reach the attic. I think that should be tall enough. Should be stable enough. Besides, what's adventure without a little risk? Awesome. There is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through. No Sharpie boob jobs. Disappointing. Her parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality from. I remember it took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time. The amulet looks kind of cool from the side. I can't get through with this chair here. I think I can squeeze through now. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult. I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack. That's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute. I need to move that desk, but this dresser is in the way. Closer. Oh, I remember when Chloe and I decorated this. More like destroyed it. It's more in the way now than when it started. Hard to imagine Chloe's dad in college. I wonder what he was like. Maybe there's still some things in there. I guess Chloe's dad went through a hippie phase. Hard to imagine Chloe's dad in college. I wonder what he was like. That's so cool. I wonder how many different moments this thing has captured. Chloe and I had the best Halloween costumes. I bet there's some good stuff still in there. Long Max Silver's eye patch. This'll be perfect. This looks like it used to be a nice desk. I guess everything ends up in an attic eventually. I never realized how much I liked vintage things. This cooler is awesome. Glad this thing is empty. So close, but I still can't get to the amulet. Yes. Finally. A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
Nothing can stop the mighty Bluebeard.
Chloe Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in his attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend, that's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. Did you find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here, we have treasure to find.
On my way.
The Dark Cavern was no match for you, eh? Long Mac Silver to the rescue.
Treasure's sure to be ours, Captain.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting it on was a lot more fun than taking it off. This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something. Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard. I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I still wish I could live in the world we drew. I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting. These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving? How am I going?
What's up, dude?
Bro.
Don't you mean sis?
Maybe I meant nerd.
Dork.
Doofus.
Only doofuses say doofus. You know what, Max Caulfield?
What, Chloe Price?
You're the frickin' best. That's all.
Talk about mushy. Where'd that come from?
I was just thinking about how awesome this day is. And how awesome we are. Okay, enough of this shit. There's treasure to be unburying. Ah, my greatest work of art. I call it how I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Great art is never appreciated.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me.
Do you drink this?
Yar! No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
That's probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair. This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning, I can. I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues. All I'm saying is, I've never broken my wrist taking a picture. I can't wait to... I wish I could freeze this moment. I never have to leave it.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Walk the plank.
Perfect. Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas. The mighty Captain Bluebeard, in all her glory.
Wait just a minute.
Yar! You must ask permission before setting foot, or peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet, coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I think I saw some tape.
Thanks, Max.
Just some tape left between us and the treasure. The mighty Captain Bluebeard. In all,
if you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Yeah, totally. But we're losers together. See?
If you're a loser, Max, I don't think I want to be cool. It's just... this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well... treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way.
I never understood why it's called a Jolly Roger. How jolly can you be if you're dead? I wish this was big enough to jump in.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive-bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks.
Score! One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
Are you ever gonna get your kite down from the roof?
It was unhappy in captivity. I set it free.
You must be a hero to kites everywhere.
I'll hold ship down while you find some tape.
Avast, matey! Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard! I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Huh, Max? Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah. Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait, how am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something.
Here goes nothing. Okay, this drawing is supposed to line up with something. I'm so close. I just need to keep looking. Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Okay, take a step right. No, no, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
That is not what we buried.
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers. It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now, you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember. Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you were so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe. You were really sweet.
Oh, man. I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now. Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff. I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at everything. I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it. Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho now. I guess, compared to that, Seattle's not so far. These used to make great pirate swords. Goodbye, Vase. Soon you won't have to worry about me knocking you over anymore. I always look especially short next to Chloe. This is probably the last thing Chloe's mom wants to see after a shift at the diner. Much better.
Somebody's a goody two-shoes.
I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic. That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast. We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me. There. Now you've got something pretty to look at. Hey, little guy. Aren't you cold in there? You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this. Recording things was so much fun in third grade. It's good to see you, old friend. Recording things was so much fun in third grade. It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move. Is writing once a week too often? Will I run out of things to say? A time capsule was such a good idea.
I know, right? We're geniuses.
This container looks like it could last 100 years. Holy crap! It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross. Lupin, we used to read every issue from cover to cover. Recording things was so much fun in third grade. Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
Ah, keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art. Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things. I guess I should try talking to Chloe again about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything. I bet there's some really cute photos in there. I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now. I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now. Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance. Hey! What if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO? I could use this to recreate that old photo of Chloe. Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
Yes?
Pose for a photo with that? Okay, tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
You're not so bad yourself.
This used to be the Rainy Day pirate ship. Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
This is Anne Rogers, Marissa's mother. Marissa from Blackwell. I need to talk to you about what your daughter did to Marissa in class today. I'll be keeping Marissa home with me tomorrow. At this point, I'm not comfortable sending her back to school. I don't know if your daughter's having trouble adjusting or what, but this needs to be addressed.
Hey, hold on.
Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Shit.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
They both sound awful.
Marissa and her mom.
They are. All Marissa talks about is, like, how much she hates her tutor, but she never does any homework.
I told you, I hate fake people.
Is everybody there like that?
No, not everyone. But more than I'm used to. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner in science. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt, not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
Is that why you wanted to throw away your hoodie?
Don't worry. I'll keep it.
Hey, you can handle this. You're so much cooler than she is.
Just to you. Thanks, Max.
You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
This moment could last forever. Take a break for a second.
This artist waits for no
one. Stop.
That was worth stopping for. I'm a little bit hungry. How about you?
I'm okay.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly. This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right? Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
Why did you pretend like you didn't know?
I don't know. I guess I didn't want it to be true. We were both doing it, weren't we? All that pirate stuff, doing the treasure hunt. Wasn't that fun?
Of course, but...
Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Black flies on the windowsill. That we are, that we are, that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land, a dark and plumed estate. Hope here needs a humble hand, not a fox found in your place.
Just a stone. absolute worst time for me to go. I thought maybe if you heard my voice, it could be a little bit like I was there. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it, great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.